Speaking with Karen Wellman this morning from Dynamic Metals. Karen, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
Very good, Karen. Look, big morning for you here with the commencement of trading on the ASX. Give us a bit of background here to Dynamic.
Yeah, it's been a very good morning for us, Dynamic. So Dynamic is a successful spin-off from Jindalee Resources. So those following the story, Jindalee Resources has been around since 2002 and built up quite a large portfolio of assets here in Australia, as well as our McDermott project over in the US, which we've had quite a bit of success with. So we made the decision through last year to separate the Australian assets from the US assets and spin off the Australian assets into this new company called Dynamic Metals. So we've just completed the IPO and successful listing on the ASX this morning.
And Dynamic has, is it three main projects in Australia?
Yeah, so Dynamic's got three main projects. We've got our Widgiemooltha project located about an hour south of Kalgoorlie, prospective for lithium, nickel and gold. We have our Lake Percy project about 100 kilometres west of Widgiemooltha, which is also prospective for lithium and nickel. And then we've got our Deep Well project, which is up in Meekatharra, so prospective for nickel and PGEs.
So as far as the flagship here, Widgiemooltha, what are your exploration plans near term?
We're planning on commencing some drilling activities there in the next couple of weeks. So we'll launch straight in with some RC drilling, followed up by some air core drilling a bit later on. So we're focusing on some of our nickel targets we've been working up over the last 12 months. And we're also simultaneously on the side working on our lithium targeting. So our lithium exploration is a bit earlier stage. So sort of going back to early sampling and mapping there. And
has there been much previous lithium exploration done?
No, the region hasn't historically really been targeted for its lithium potential, but you can see that it's emerging in recent times. You've seen Widgie Nickel had success with the Faraday discovery, and just last week the deal with Essential Metals has done, a bit of consolidation happening in lithium field there. We're surrounded by lithium deposits, so we really believe that there's a lot of potential to come from there, but we don't have any data to go on. So, yeah, we step back to basics there with our sampling and mapping.
Just as far as the team at Dynamic, you mentioned Cassini. I see you've secured the services of one of the geologists involved in that discovery.
Yes, yeah. So in terms of the team, we've got our exploration manager, Jimmy, and myself, but also we've got Tan Doan, who is on board as our nickel technical advisor. So he has been working with us for over a year now and developing those nickel targets. He's credited with at least five nickel discoveries in the region. So he comes with quite a good pedigree and he's an absolute gem to have on board.
What do you reckon makes, when it comes to your peer group, what makes Dynamic Metals interesting? What makes it stand out?
I think we've got such a large portfolio of assets, but also there's depth to them. So as I mentioned, like with the Widgiemooltha area, we've got some really good nickel targets, got some very strong gold targets, but then we've also got this amazing potential for lithium as well. So, we've got a lot going for us. And that also occurs when you look at Lake Percy, and then we've also got that sort of a bit more of a wild card aspect with the exploration work that we've got planned up for a deep well. So yeah, we've got quite a lot of depth, got a lot of experience. We've been working on these assets. We're quite familiar with them. So Jimmy and I have both been with the company for nearly 2 years. So we've been working with these projects for a long time. So we're not just starting from scratch. We're ready to go and moving forward.
Well, wishing you all the best for the upcoming exploration. Karen, thanks for your time.
No worries. Thanks, Andrew.